गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड चैप्टर 4 ऑफ पॉलिटिकल साइंस, इलेक्टोरल पॉलिटिक्स, पार्ट 4. टुडे वी विल रीड दैट व्हाट इज आवर सिस्टम ऑफ इलेक्शंस. वी शुड नो अबाउट आवर इलेक्शन सिस्टम. द लोकसभा एंड द विधानसभा इलेक्शंस आर हेल्ड इन इंडिया आफ्टर एवरी 5 ईयर्स. द लोकसभा इलेक्शन इज कॉल्ड द जनरल इलेक्शन. देयर आर सर्टेन इलेक्शंस that are conducted in a particular constituencies owing to the death or resignation of a member. These are known as by-elections. Now let us talk about the electoral constituencies in detail. The country is divided into electoral constituencies for both the Lok Sabha and the Legislative Assembly election. One representative is elected from each constituency by the voter. The country is divided into 543 constituencies for the Lok Sabha elections. The selected representative is called the Member of Parliament or MP. Similarly, each state is divided into a number of assembly constituencies, and the representative selected from each constituency is called the Member of Legislative Assembly, or you can say MLA. For Lok Sabha elections, the country is divided into 543 constituencies. You can see on the map here. The representative elected from each constituency is called the Member of Parliament here. Now let us talk about some reserved constituencies and election procedures as well. In open electoral competitions, certain weaker sections of the society may not stand a good chance of winning because of the influence of powerful sections. Hence, the makers of our constitution prepared a system of reserved constituencies for these weaker sections. Certain constituencies are reserved for the people belonging to the scheduled caste and the scheduled tribes. In the Lok Sabha, seats reserved for SC and STs are 79 and 41 respectively. These are proportioned to their population in the total population of the country. Seats are reserved for the other backward classes as well. Those are called OBC. They may not have the required resources, education and contacts to contest and win election. Now let us talk about the voter list. As all of you know that we are the voter, and what is voter list here? In a democratic election, the list of those who are eligible to cast vote is prepared much before the election and given to everyone. This list is officially called as the electoral roll or voter list, and commonly known as the voters list. This is an important step, for it is linked to first condition of a democratic election. Everyone should get an equal opportunity to choose representatives. Thank you. Next, we will read in our next module.